Hello? 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 Anybody? Anybody? Hello? Hermits? Is there anybody here? Hello? Hello?
Greetings, cyberdogs and citizens of the interwebs. This is Ren digging in Nauga coming at ya in another Minecraft episode from the Hermitcraft server. Oh, it feels so good to be back on the Hermitcraft server, guys. I have, of course, been on holiday with my parents for the last couple of weeks, and I'm finally back in the world of the interwebs. Although, I gotta say, I'm a little bit confused. I logged onto the server yesterday only to find that Hermit Island was completely deserted. I couldn't find a single hermit anywhere in any district. And as my parents and I had spent our vacation driving around 700 miles across England, I didn't have a chance to actually follow what was going on the server. So, I had to take a bit of time off to try and figure out exactly what's going down around here. And for those of you who are perhaps as confused as the Ren Diggity Dog, let me try and break it down for you. At some point during my holiday, the server was updated to Minecraft 1.14. This prompted a bunch of the hermits to head out into new chunks to find the very first 1.14 village on the server. After many shenanigans and a janky green flying machine, the hermits settled in this little village over here, which has now been called Hermitville. And the idea was for every single hermit to claim themselves a building and a villager and to set up a fully functioning 1.14 village all the way out here in the middle of freaking nowhere. And so the hermits got to work building their buildings and naming their villages, but unfortunately, they were hit by some serious Minecraft 1.14 bugs, which resulted in the near destruction of every single villager in Hermitville. There were two major bugs that contributed to this apocalypse, the first being a lighting bug, which actually stopped Minecraft recognizing light sources as light sources, and thus zombies and mobs were spawning all over Hermitville. And the second bug, potentially the more devastating one, was that some of the hermits found themselves in an infinite raid loop with the pillagers and ravagers that were trying to decimate the population of Hermitville. Now, the wonderful Izuma Void is putting in a ton of work to try and solve these issues on the server, and hopefully these bugs will be eliminated in the next pre-release. But until then, it looks like Hermitville has become a little bit of a ghost town, as a bunch of the hermits are potentially keeping away from this place until these very devastating bugs are sorted out. My fellow hermits have also spent many hours out here trying to do bug testing and bug fixes and whatnot, and I kind of feel a little bit bad that I wasn't able to contribute to that. So in today's episode, my friends, I thought maybe what we could do is try and help some of our fellow hermits out by doing a few projects here in Hermitville that is going to help to relieve some of the stress that some of our hermits are feeling out here in our 1.14 village. And with all that now being said, we've got our work cut out for us today, guys. All right, my dudes, time to get down to some business up in here. And as the latest citizen of Hermitville, our first task is to choose a place to live. As we are pretty late to the party over here, most of the houses have been claimed already. I think this is for the convexes. That's Eskull over there. Stress is over there. Green is in that really cool looking house all the way over there. I think Doc lives inside of that box. And Falsy has created for herself a little bit of a camper van over there to live in. And I think Impulse is around here somewhere too. And that big building at the back there, that's Zuma's place. Now, I've gone through the village trying to find myself a suitable spot to live. And the only houses that are really appealing to me are these two very small ones on top of the hill in the center of the town. Unfortunately though, they are extremely small. Look at this. There's going to be absolutely no space to do anything in here. So what I'm thinking here is that we're going to take both of these houses for ourselves, and maybe what we can do is link them up and make them one nice big house in the middle. Ooh, the sun is setting over here. I actually have a bed in my inventory for this exact moment. There goes Stress Monster 101 over there. And well, it's very important that we sleep as that sun sets, just in case the lighting glitches kick in around the village. So let's get this night slept away and start claiming some houseage. Now, I gotta say, my friends, I'm pretty excited to be playing Minecraft today, because this is the very first time that I am playing in Minecraft 1.14, and there are a whole bunch of really cool things that I want to try out. Not only do we have a whole bunch of new slabs and stairs and whatnot, but there's a couple of very interesting little tricks that we can do take a look at this. I've got a couple of signs on our houses over here. This is Randog's humble abode, and this is Randog's shed. And apparently, we can actually change the color of text on signs now by applying a little bit of dye to them. Let's take a look if this is going to work. Boom, look at that. Beautiful. We're going to change that to red. We'll change this one to red too, because, you know, red is kind of our thing. We're kind of red, Well, our shirt is red anyway. But there we go. We've claimed a couple of houses here in Hermitville, guys. Randog's humble abode and Randog's shed. And boom, there we go. We've now got a couple of houses here in Hermitville. Oh, baby, that bamboo looks absolutely awesome, doesn't it, guys? I really love the little bit of leaves all the way at the top of the shoots over here. And I gotta be honest, one of the things that I was most excited about when I saw the spoilers for 1.14 was the scaffolding block. That is something that I've been looking forward to in Minecraft for a very, very long time. And I thought maybe we could do a little bit of experimenting here with scaffolding. And this is why you do your research before you start recording, Randog, you derp. Listen, my dudes, I'm a little bit rusty right now, okay? I've gone through the recipe book here to find the scaffolding, and it looks like we're gonna need some string to make some scaffolding, which is unfortunate because I don't have any string, although I have a lot of bamboo. Any spiders around here? I've just stumbled across what looks to be a workstation area. I think this is probably all of Azumavoid's resources here, and there is actually some string in one of these shulker boxes. Hopefully Azumavoid won't mind if I borrow a little bit of string, but I'm kind of curious to see what the scaffolding block looks like. There is the recipe. Let's craft a bunch of those for us. And yeah, that is what scaffolding looks like. Pretty cool. And man, I don't really know what to do with this, to be honest. We haven't really started building anything yet, but maybe I can figure out something over here at Randog's shed. Now that's a bit of awesomeness that I did not expect today, guys. Here I am in Azumavoid's cathedral, and these scaffolding blocks kind of remind me of a construction site or something, right? It's actually really cool to see them inside here. You know, usually all of this stuff would be dirt pillars and it would look absolutely terrible. But this has got me a little bit inspired. Maybe what we can do is use the scaffolding block to make our houses look like they are under construction or something like that, right? And that's going to show all the other hermits out here that this area has been claimed by the Rendigated Dog and that an awesome structure of awesomeness is incoming. Or something. I definitely should not be getting this excited about scaffolding, guys. This block is so freaking sweet. Take a look at this. If you right-click on the side of a scaffolding block, it will go up. And take a listen to the sound it makes when it breaks. Oh man, that is so satisfying. I've been experimenting a little bit here with the scaffolding, trying to figure out exactly how it works. I really like how easy it is to go upwards like this, and I think the way that we climb scaffolding is going into the middle of it and then just climbing upwards. Yes, there we go. I think there's also a way for us to build in a horizontal direction from this position over here, and I think what we do is just click on the top of it. Yes, there we go. And that's going to build in that direction. I guess it goes in the direction that we're facing. If we face this way, yes, it's going to go in that direction. That is so freaking sweet. I love that. How far can we actually go? I think there's actually a limit to it. And then what happens is the scaffolding starts falling downwards. Yeah, so that's not quite working out the way that I planned. Also, sun is going down, so I think it's probably time to sleep before there's another bugopalypse around here. Ooh, I must remember to break the bed after sleeping, guys. We've been chatting on our Hermitcraft Discord about trying to prevent the raid issues that we've been having on the server, and one of the suggestions that has been made is that we don't have any beds in the village, and that will stop the raid spawning until the bug is fixed. So it's really important that we don't die right now. What I'm finding most interesting about this scaffolding block is that it doesn't really function in the way that other Minecraft blocks function. For example, normally, if we wanted to place a block on top of another block, we would simply right-click on top of that block. But of course, in scaffolding, that actually builds the scaffolding out in the different directions. So I guess you gotta learn how to use scaffolding if you don't want it to make you go absolutely cray-cray up in this business. But as far as I'm concerned, this is one of my new favorite blocks. I'm not entirely sure what it is about these scaffolding blocks that I like so much, guys, but they are an absolute blast to play with. I really enjoy placing them down, and I think it's probably the sounds that I like the most. And the ease of breaking them too. They just break with one punch, which is fantastic. Still trying to get used to actually using these bad boys, but we now have a little bit of a construction site going on over here. We better sleep in a moment though, but let's take a real quick look at it. Yeah, that's looking absolutely fantastic. Any hermit coming out here will definitely know that something is up over here. something is being constructed, and that something is the humble abode of Ren Diggity Dog. Nice. Feeling good, Cyber Diggity Dogs. We now got ourselves a place to live here in Hermitville. And next up, I would like to start working on helping out my fellow hermits with dealing with them pesky raids. I've actually not had the opportunity to fight a raid just yet in 1.14. And to be honest with you, I'm not entirely sure I want to fight a raid. If one does trigger, however, I would like to be as prepared as possible. And what I'm thinking is the first thing that we could do out here as a form of defense against the raid is set up a lovely big wall that is going to be surrounding the entire village over here. And, well, raiders are kind of scary, but at the same time, they are kind of dumb. And they don't know how to climb walls. And I think if we can set up a really nice wall around our village, that's going to really help with the hermits fighting off the raids when they actually spawn. Also, just spotted a couple of llamas and a fool over here. Hello? What is this? Oh, I think this is the traveling merchant that is new to 1.14. What do you have to trade over here? Tulips, oxeye daisies, cactuses, poppies, allium, and some packed ice. My dude, you suck. First things first for our wall project over here, guys, is to clear the outside perimeter of trees. That's going to make it much easier for us hermits to battle the raids when they actually do come. I think a raid can come from any direction, and once this wall has been erected, the raiders will get sort of stuck against the wall because they're idiots and they don't know how to use ladders, apparently. But in order for us to be able to kill the raids efficiently, of course, we need to have a lot of space. I think what we can do is create some sort of a barricade on top of the wall, perhaps, and then we can shoot the raiders down with arrows, or, I don't know, maybe we can find some creative ways to kill the raiders themselves. But before we get to any of that sweet jazz, we need to get this wall erected, and we need to make it as, well, foolproof as possible for anybody who is going to be fighting the raids. It's the next day in real life, my friends, and an absolute butt ton of awesome things have been going down here in Hermitville between yesterday and today, starting with the completion of the anti-raid wall. Oh yes, this bad boy is looking absolutely amazing right now. We're currently running along the top of the balustrade, and I want to say a big thanks to Stress and Iskull, who hopped onto the server last night to help me finish this wall off. Took us about 4 hours or so to complete it, and I gotta say, man, it is looking really, really sweet. Also, last night at about 1 o'clock in the morning, just as the three of us were about to log off and go to sleep, the village got raided by 4 simultaneous raid parties, and well, that was kind of bad news. However, the wall did an absolutely amazing job keeping the majority of the raid outside of the inside of Hermitville, and we managed to actually defeat the raid, which was really, really sweet. However, it's a little bit of bad news, because during my recording yesterday, Azuma updated the server to 1.14.2 pre-release 4, which actually fixed the lighting bug on the server, which is amazing news. So light sources are now functioning as they are supposed to. However, it looks like a pre-4 has not fixed the raid bug, as while Iskall Stress and I were defending against the first raid, we actually triggered another 3 raids on top of that one. So by the end of it, we were fighting off 4 simultaneous raids, which was pretty intense. But we managed to secure a victory and defend the village successfully. Now, the lovely Stress Monster 101 actually helped me out all day yesterday on the server, which was amazing. And I did manage to convince it to help me out with another task, which we're going to take a look at in a moment, which was to repopulate Hermitville after the destruction it received last week. But before we get to that awesomeness, I wanted to show you a little bit of the work that I actually did on the wall. Some really cool, interesting things going on over here. So the wall is about 5 blocks high, and we've gone with a cobblestone and spruce log primary block palette so that it matches the rest of the village over here. And Iskall actually had a really sweet idea about using these newly colored signs that we get in 1.14. These are actually spruce colored signs to create the barriers for the balustrade on the top, which I think looks really, really sweet. It's not exactly the most complicated wall design in the world, but most importantly, it is very good at defending raids. We have this walkway or this rampart at the top of the wall, and from up here you can really defend against the raids that are coming into the village, which is kind of awesome. But I do want to spend a little bit more time over the coming weeks or so sort of improving the look of the wall. But for now, this bad boy is doing its job, keeping those filthy illagers away from Hermitville, and hopefully it'll do a great job at protecting all the brand new villagers that are about to arrive here. Speaking of new villagers, I got a little bit of help from Stress Monster 101 in my mission to repopulate Hermitville. Okay, you ready? Mm-hmm. 3, 2, One. Okay, let's try this again.
That was your fault, not mine.
Yeah, that was completely my fault. Stress, thanks so much for helping me with the wall.
You're very welcome, Ren.
Yeah.
I have to say, it was the highlight of my life.
Yes.
Building a wall around the new lands.
Hermitville.
Yeah. Hermitville.
lots of the hermits are in Sweden at the Creators Summit. We're all alone. So
it looks like we're in Sweden, though.
Yeah.
Look at the trees, kind of.
It does look like we're in Sweden, actually.
We could be in the forest, and we've made our own little campfire, and we're all snuggly next to it because it's still snowing in Sweden. I don't know.
This villager speak? Do you speak Swedish? Wait, was that Swedish?
Ah, do är svenska.
Du är svenska Swedish.
God knows if that's even right, but you are now on a pumpkin. I'm removing that.
Okay. Stress, listen.
Yes.
I have another task for you. I've kind of roped you into the tree. The village is giving you the eyeball. Dude, get out of here.
We've
got business to attend
me.
To. Yeah, he does.
You just scared him away, Ren. Like, he was my lover.
Well, you got another one incoming. Damn, girl.
Men, get in line. He's like, no, I'm off. Oh, yeah. No, he is. Look at this, Ren. Look.
Well, listen, he's very stinky. This guy hasn't showered in days. Get out of here, you stupid idiot. Jeez. Okay, can we get down to business, please?
He's after you now, right? Oh,
sorry, geez.
But he is.
Okay.
Look.
Hi.
Look at them eyeballs.
Yes. Hi. this is awkward.
Maybe we should move away back to the campfire.
Okay, let's go back to the campfire. Okay, so listen, I've roped you in to make the wall. That was awesome. It took half the time because you were helping.
Yes.
And
I was so much help.
The next task in my episode is to repopulate Hermitville because there was an apocalypse and they all died while I was on holiday. So,
yeah.
I want to do something nice for the hermits that are in Sweden. When they get back, there'll be a whole bunch of new villages for them, right?
It sounds perfect.
So, what we're going to do is transport all of these villages from this village to Hermitville.
Okay.
Hermitville is somewhere over there.
Okay.
Over there. Okay.
Yeah, in that said direction.
In that said direction. So, what we're going to do, we're going to make a bridge of dirt with rails on top, right?
Sounds perfect. Mm-hmm.
And then we're going to put the Swedes in the mine carts. And
are they all going to be Swedes?
Yeah, they're all Swedes.
Are all the new villagers in the new lands, they're just going to be Swedes?
They're going to be Swedish. Stress Monster, seriously, if anyone from Mojang is watching this, can we please just lure villagers with emeralds? Please?
Yeah. That was effort.
Yeah. These are all the villagers.
Yeah, this one here. I think it was this one.
Yeah.
Kept legging it, didn't he?
Yeah, he wasn't happy with being... I mean, look, we have literally ripped them out of their childhood home. But, you know, it's for the greater good.
Of course, that's what we keep telling each other.
Yeah.
So,
the next task... This is basically just a quick showing of how we're going to do this. We're going to set up rails, or should we say sections of rails, all the way from here over to Hermitville. We don't have enough rails to make an entire line, but we'll do it in, like, segments, you know?
Yeah, so we'll get them in the end.
Stress, look at them. They've lost their jobs, I think.
They're no longer cute.
Yeah, they're all just hobos now, I think.
They have no jobs.
We made pretty good progress, though. We are literally, well, a stone throw away from Hermitville, kind of.
We're getting there.
Yeah.
You've done a good job doing all the dirt. I haven't done such a good job getting them along the dirt.
Well, I think it's been slow going, but it's been pretty fun. We've been hanging out, just chilling, you know. It's now almost midnight on a Friday, so, you know, we have lives. So this is great. Stress!
Ren!
Stress!
Stress! Ren!
Stress! Unleash the villagers!
Okay. hang on. There we go. They're coming.
They're coming.
Some of them are coming. Can you see them?
Yes. Nice.
Here come the other lot.
Here they come. This has taken way too long for my liking, but here we go. They're about to land inside of the villager pit. No, one got stuck.
I haven't seen the villager pit. Hang on. I'm legging it behind the last one.
Okay. Are you going to be the last one into the pit? Nice.
I'm going to be the last one in the pit.
Where are you, Stress?
I'm coming. Are they safe in the pit?
Yeah, they're safe. They Everybody's died. Happy. One of them's put a hat on, actually. Going to get a bit of a suntan.
Shut up.
Yeah.
Has he decided he wants to work? Oh, my God. Oh, look at him. He's like, yeah, that's it. I'm home.
Yeah. Welcome home, Swedes. Love is in the air.
And we need babies.
Yeah, we do. I mean, okay. Be very careful, though. If you hit the villager, they will hate you forever.
Okay.
Let's get rid of the rails first.
Okay.
Right?
Okay. Why is this
so they stop moving. Oh, okay. This is...
Okay. I'm yellow. Huh! I did one! Huh!
Huh.
Yes.
Huh.
Okay. Make a baby. Oh, look. Run. Huh. They might make a baby run.
Come on, please.
Give us a baby. No, don't look at me. I can't do the same that other villager can do. No.
Come on, guys. You can do it. Come on. Jeez, there is a lot of loving happening in this pit, Stress. And it kind of concerns me. It's not very hygienic in here, if I'm honest with you. Baby, Stress. It's a baby.
Baby.
No, he escaped.
No. The baby's gone.
No, he went to jump on the bed. Look at him. He's adorable.
He's playing.
Big thanks to Iskull came to help us figure out how to breed the villagers. Just added some beds close by. He loves you, Stress. You're his momsy.
I don't think he loves me very much, actually.
Oh, hi, Iskull. Well, Stress, our job here is done.
It is. It looks amazing.
Yeah, those villagers are so beautiful, aren't they?
Look at the mini Stress.
It's so cute. Look at it.
Hello. So
yeah. Hermits, if you want more villagers, come to the jank hole, because there's loads. Well, guys, I gotta say, it's been a rather adventurous return to the Hermitcraft server for me. A very busy last couple of days. But I'm very pleased to announce that we have got a whole bunch of new villagers here into Hermitville. It's a rather disturbing sight indeed, seeing all of those Ren Dogs and Stress Monsters in there. But this is, well, the start of a brand new little business venture for us over here. I figured we spend so much time getting these villagers over here, we might as well make a little bit of a profit from it. So this is Ren Dog's Breeding Pit Shop, which is coming soon. And hopefully some of the hermits living out here will want to spend a little bit of diamonds, potentially, on getting themselves a couple new villagers out of the pit. This, of course, is the head of a Vex, which we got from defending those four raids I was telling you about. But that's going to do it from me on the Hermitcraft server today, guys. I hope you have enjoyed the episode. Hey, listen, if you have enjoyed it, don't forget to smash the like button. Really helps me out. And of course, if you want to continue watching the series and keeping up to date with what's cracking up in here, don't forget to smash that subscribe button too. Guys, thank you so much for watching. Ren Diggity Dogga signing out from Hermitville. We'll smell you all in the next episode.